Hey guys, what's up? Today we'll be talking about ways to import and export your database. There are a lot of people who prefer using the MongoDB command line tool, so in case you're a fan of this as well, you can go check out the official MongoDB documentation on the matter. I will include a link to it in the description of the video in case you're interested. Still, the majority of our customers prefer using MongoDB clients for import and export. There are plenty of options available online, so you can choose the one depending on your personal preferences. Today we'll be talking about Studio S3, or also known as MongoChef. In order to import or export your database using a MongoDB client, you of course first need to download and install the client on your device, and then you will need a connection string to your database. You can find the connection string to your database by logging into your apps dashboard, going to your apps, then you will click on app settings. And once there, you will look for security and keys. Right there, you will find your database URL. So right now, I will just copy it and I will open my MongoDB client. So for Studio S3, I will just click on connect. I will then click on new connection. I will choose from URA. Then I will paste the connection string to my database and I will click on OK. Once this is done, I will click on Save. Right here, I just need to click once and then click on Connect. Right now, the connection to the database is establishing, and right here on the left side, I can already see my database and its collections. The process will be pretty much similar with any other MongoDB client. So what I will do now will be to choose a collection of my choice, then I will export it, I will clear the collection and I will import the content back. So for example, let's choose the catalog collection. I will just click twice on it. Then I will right click, and once I do it, here I see a menu with a couple of different options, and here is the export collection option. I just select it, then a window appears asking me for the type of file I would like to export to. I will choose JSON, then I will click Next. Here I will again click Next. I can specify the location of the file where I would like to save it. I will save it in my SashiDo video series folder. Then I will click Next and start export. That's it pretty much. Right here on the left side, I can see that 7 documents have been successfully exported. So this is the collection that I have just exported. Now I will go back to MongoChef and I will clear the collection. I will do it by right-clicking on the collection itself and clicking on Clear Collection. I confirm that I'm sure by again clicking on Clear Collection, and within a couple of seconds the content is erased. So if I go back to the dashboard now and just refresh, I shouldn't be able to see any content. Let's just check it. So as you can see, we don't have any data to display. Now it's time to return back the content that we have just deleted. We'll go back to the MongoDB client, and this time we'll import the collection. The import happens the same way as the export. We just right-click on the collection and then we choose Import Data. We can choose the type of file. In my case, I will go for JSON. I will click on Next. Here, I will specify the file that I will be importing. Then I click on Next. And the final step is to click on Start Import. Within a couple of seconds, the collection should be imported. I can double check it by going back to the dashboard and again refreshing. So within a few seconds, my content should appear again. And here it is. As you saw, the process of import and export using MongoChef is a pretty straightforward one and very easy, and it is the same with any other MongoDB client. I hope the information has been useful to you guys, and thanks for watching. See you next week. Bye bye.